When you hear the word Vikings, what pops into your head? Giant blonde warriors with horned helmets sailing around and starting trouble? Well, you might want to throw out about half of that image. The real Vikings came from Scandinavia. That's Denmark in the south, Sweden in the east, and Norway up north. Three countries, one shared reputation, being fearless travelers, and leaving a massive impact wherever they landed. But Vikings weren't some pure, isolated master race. Nope. Their DNA reveals a crazy story of mixing, mingling, and basically turning the medieval world into the ultimate game of who's your ancestor. New research has cracked open hundreds of Viking graves, and what was found changes everything you thought you knew about them. Get ready, because Viking history just got a lot messier and way more interesting. Okay, before we dive into the science, let's clear up some classic Viking myths. First big one, Vikings weren't one single people. They were a mix of groups from across Scandinavia, Denmark, Sweden, and Norway, each with their own agendas, their own fashion crimes, and apparently their own travel plans.
Så for eksempel vikingerne, der kunne vi så se, at vikingerne, det er ikke en bestemt etnisk gruppe. Det er ikke sådan, at man kan sige, at alle vikingerne kom bare fra Skandinavien. Det er en multietnisk gruppe. Det er altså en livsstil, som folk tager til sig, i modsætning til hvad man troede.
Yep. Being a Viking was less about where you came from, and more about whether you could row, raid, and rock a battle axe. Also, bad news, there were no horned helmets. Those were invented by costume designers in the 1800s, not actual Viking warriors. Real Viking helmets? Much more practical, much less cosplay, and maybe most surprising, not every Viking was a bloodthirsty raider. Many were farmers, traders, explorers. Some were basically just trying to find a nicer piece of land without freezing to death. But whether they were fighting, farming, or flirting their way across Europe, one thing's for sure. The Vikings left their mark, not just on history books, but deep in the genes of the modern world. So, how do we actually know all this? Well, thanks to a team of scientists and a lot of Viking bones, we finally cracked open the genetic story of the Norse. Researchers analyzed the DNA from 442 Viking skeletons, found everywhere from Denmark and England to Russia and even Greenland. Yeah, Greenland. Talk about dedication to finding new lands. And okay, sure, it was a bit warmer in Greenland back then, but more on that in another video. What they found blew away centuries of myths.
Men vi kan også se, at vikingtiden er ikke en periode, hvor at man mødtes alle mulige steder fra i Skandinavien og tog på tog sammen. Altså det er fætter Bent og kusinen, du ved, fra den lille lokale landsby, der tog ud og raider. Og i det hele taget, så må man sige, at vikingtiden er karakteriseret ved, at man har et enormt stort udsyn på hele verden, men en meget lille interesse for, hvad der egentlig foregår i Skandinavien.
And get this. The study even found that a lot of the Vikings raiding England weren't pure Scandinavians at all. Some had recent Scottish and Irish ancestry, others totally local. They were people who had joined the Viking lifestyle. Basically, Viking was less like a passport and more like a career choice. But here's an even bigger twist. When Vikings went on raids, it wasn't some United Nations of Scandinavian bad boys teaming up. Nope, it was often basically a small family road trip. Only instead of postcards, they sent back stolen treasure. In short, Vikings were multicultural, hypermobile, and a lot less organized than Hollywood wants you to believe. Okay, so the Vikings didn't just travel far. They went full-on world tour. From the British Isles to the Russian steppe, Viking DNA pops up like a bad song you can't stop hearing. But here's the kicker. They didn't just fight, they stayed, settled, intermarried, made babies, lots of babies. And their DNA ended up everywhere. Take England, for example. Especially in the East, Danish Vikings settled in big numbers, and we're not just talking burly bearded dudes. The study found that Scandinavian women moved west too, suggesting that this wasn't just hit and run. It was more like hit, marry, farm, repeat. The Danes were basically the kings of the Western Viking scene. From their strongholds in southern Scandinavia, they launched raids and settlements not just in England, but also across northern France, where they eventually became the Normans, and even up the rivers of Ireland. They were in Dublin before it was cool, ran coastal towns like Waterford and Limerick, and turned the Irish Sea into their personal swimming pool of commerce and chaos. So, yeah, when it comes to the Danes, think less brief vacation and more hostile real estate acquisition with long-term plans. Meanwhile, Norwegian Vikings took the scenic route through Ireland and Scotland, leaving behind both their swords and their chromosomes, and they didn't stop there. Norwegian Vikings also made their way to the Faroe Islands, Iceland, and eventually all the way to Greenland, turning the North Atlantic into their personal stepping stones. And let's not forget Leif Erikson, the guy who straight up beat Columbus to North America by about 500 years. We're not just talking sagas here. Archaeologists have literally found the remains of a Viking settlement at Lons-o-Meadows in Newfoundland, Canada. We're talking longhouses, blacksmith workshops, and over 800 artifacts, including butternuts, which only grow further south, suggesting they explored even more of the continent. So yeah, Vikings in America. And Swedish Vikings? They had their eyes on the east, the Baltics, modern-day Ukraine, and deep into Russia. That's right, they basically founded what would become the Russian state. So next time someone tells you Vikings were all about the west, just point east and say, "Actually?" Long story short, wherever the Vikings went, they didn't just leave ruins, they left relatives. All right, brace yourself, because this study didn't just tweak the Viking story, it flipped the whole longship. First off, a bunch of Vikings buried in Scandinavia itself had non-Scandinavian DNA. Yeah, some of the Vikings who stayed home were more genetically foreign than the ones who left. That means the whole idea of a pure Viking race is, surprise, complete historical fan fiction. Also, did you know that many of the Viking warriors buried in England had roots in Scotland and Ireland? Which means, in some cases, they might have been fighting their own cousins. Meanwhile, Swedish Vikings weren't even that active in the West. Instead, they were busy expanding trade routes through Eastern Europe, doing business with the Byzantines, and founding places like Kiev. In fact, they had a name, the Rus. Yep, as in Russia. And they weren't just swinging swords. They were out there trading furs, silver, and even slaves. Viking business, baby. One of their wildest journeys? Sailing all the way down to Constantinople, modern-day Istanbul, and working as elite guards for the Byzantine Emperor. They were known as the Varangian Guard. Imagine Vikings with top-tier armor, palace access, and a solid dental plan. And they didn't just act the part. They looked it. These elite guards were recognized by their long hair, a red ruby set in the left ear, and fearsome dragons sewn into their chainmail shirts. Not exactly your average Scandinavian sheep farmer. And the coolest part? One of them even left a message behind. Scratched into the marble walls of the Hagia Sophia Church, you can still see it today. A simple rune graffiti that says, "Halvdan was here." Because even 1,000 years ago, guys named Halvdan couldn't resist tagging their name on historic landmarks. So yeah, Vikings didn't just leave behind myths and ruins. They left carvings, kids, and cultural footprints across continents. And depending on where they came from, each group had their own style. Let's break it down. Basically, Danish Vikings equals pub crawl through England. Norwegian Vikings equals wild tour of Ireland and the Atlantic. Swedish Vikings equals business class to the east. And finally, this one's juicy. Being a Viking wasn't something you were born as. It was something you became, a choice, a lifestyle, like CrossFit, but with more axes and fewer protein shakes. As Eska Willerslev put it,
man begynder at forstå virkeligheden, og virkeligheden er en anden end den vi troede.
And that's what makes Viking DNA so fascinating. It doesn't just change the history books, it rewrites the whole Viking saga. So what have we learned from digging up Viking bones, sequencing ancient genomes, and decoding the myths? Well, turns out, Vikings weren't just a bunch of blonde berserkers swinging axes and shouting Valhalla at everything that moved. They were traders, settlers, explorers, and let's be honest, surprisingly effective at spreading their genes across half the known world. And with all this new DNA evidence, there's a good chance that you, yes, you, might have a little Viking in you. Maybe your great-great-great-great-great-grandparent was swinging a sword in York, bartering in Novgorod, or carving their name into a church wall in Constantinople. So, next time someone tells you history is boring, remind them that science just proved your ancestors might have set fire to half of Europe. And hey, if you do have Viking blood, you're legally obligated to hit that like subscribe button with a battle axe.